Welcome. Y'all ready? It's going down. Ladies. Is she the new? Is she the truth? Or is it false? Eyelashes, lip gloss. How much did that cost? Ain't no BS, boss. Left being employed, she got a show. Floss, dentistry, officer in the streets, local or industry, Ghana or Italy, Bishop or Kennedy, her drive infinity. You feeling me? Keisha that Q45 ninja, it's finna be on like a double OTD in front of your PC. We running your TVs, pouring up weekly beauty tips and health. If you don't watch it for celebs, watch it for your damn self. She got a show.
Akeisha Lockhart here for She's Got a Show, and I'm hanging out with my next guest at one of my new favorite spots. It's a little gym in Chicago on the north side called Drop. If you're ever in Chicago or you live in Chicago, stop by here. It, like I said, it's my new favorite place. It's a bar. It's a DJ lounge. It's got a little bit of everything. Great atmosphere, great service. Come in and check the place out. But let's get to my guest, comedian Lil Rel. He is kind of like a big deal. I mean, he's humble, but I'll just say it. He's one of the cast members in the new sketch comedy called Friends of the People. It's going to be on True TV October 28th. Without further ado, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, no problem. So how you been?
I've been good. Just working hard and getting ready for the premiere of this show and, you know, touring and promoting it and being very excited and nervous at the same time.
Okay. So talk about the show, Friends of the People. Uh-huh. What is it about for all those people out there that have not seen the first episode, which I watched it. I got to meet the friends. But tell everybody out there what the show is about and how you ended up being one of the cast members.
The show is about, it's basically a sketch comedy series where we're taking on just different things that goes on in the world and whatever we think is funny. You know, we're all comedians. We're all a really good friends and honestly decided to do a show together. We're all signed to the same management, basically got the same agent. So it made sense, man. We decided to do like a Wu-Tang type of all-star team of comedy thing. And it honestly turned out way better than we thought.
Okay, so, I mean, I know you just said you all have the same management. You decided to do this. But how does True TV end up picking it up? I think there has to be a little bit more to this, how this thing happened.
Well, we had our first... I mean, this is number one how it happened. It all happened because of the In Living Color thing. And we'll talk about that later, I think. But me, Jennifer, and Jermaine were cast on the In Living Color reboot. Whatever happened with that fell through. But we all became really close friends during that whole process. And we was at a festival in Montreal. And I could have just been talking crazy, to be honest. Like, man, we should do our own show, you know? And at the time, he wasn't my manager, but he's my manager now. And I was telling him that. He's like, okay, we can do that. I'm like, okay. I was just talking stuff. And I got back to Chicago, and he called me. He's like, yo, can you come to New York in the next few days? I want to meet with all you guys and see if you could come up with a show idea. It's kind of like, well, I guess we're going to have to do our own things or whatever. Our manager, Avi Gilbert, shouts out to Avi, said, okay, look, I sent the pilot to True, and I think he might have been like NBC. And they both show interest, but okay. True really was interested in it. And I remember telling them, like, I'd rather go to a network that doesn't have anything like that. And there's no disrespect to Comedy Central or NBC or anybody else. I want to go somewhere where they're excited about doing. Because I saw what, like, those shows did for AMC, like Breaking Bad and Mad Men, whatever. Like, they blew that network up because they never had anything like that. Right. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, yo, if we can be True's first series like that, let's do it. And True were great. They gave us a great deal. You know, they had money because they got a number of reality shows, so they ain't paying them people. I'm playing.
Okay.
But I mean, they gave us a great deal, and they gave us freedom, and that's the big part of it. We all wrote, produced everything.
My best friend and I watched it, and my best friend watched it, and we called each other like, "Did you see that?" And this was my favorite part. No, this was my favorite part. No, I love that part. I love that part too. So if you all have not checked out the episode, the first episode, like the Meet the Friends, a little snippets of what you guys are in store for, check that out. You can check it out on allineedisonemic.com, on our Facebook page, Twitter, all that stuff, because we're promoting the heck out of this man and what he's doing. So follow him, follow us. You can see it like that. But something that I really love about what you said is that, and I don't know if budding artists really understand the importance of being able to write and being a producer and not just being a face, because you're not just going to clubs and being a comedian and leaving. Like, you're writing and doing all that. You wear many hats.
Right.
So can you please talk to all of the up and coming comedians out there and artists in general, because not only is that putting more money in your pocket, but it's also giving you a sense of power, I would assume. So talk about the importance of that.
Well, you know, and I say this a lot of times to young comics, that, look, no, all of us not going to be stars, number one. Everybody not going to end up in front of this camera. So I would take on other skills. There's so many ways to make money in this business. But it starts with that pen first. So if you're able to write, you're able to structure a script, you're able to write jokes for somebody else, you'll make a lot of... I got friends in this business that's been writers for years, and they're making... It ain't about the money, but they're happy. You know what I mean? They always working on somebody. Like, one of the writers we had on the show, Hugh Moore, one of my good friends, we went to, where did we go? This TNT thing or whatever, and Nick Cannon and everybody was there. They're like, yo, Hugh, what you working on now? Like, trying to steal him back. And it gave us credibility because we hired him on our show. I was so happy he was able to do our show. And a lot of those hilarious, like, smart, hysterical sketches, even some of the stuff, you know, he was like my writing partner too. So that's who I wrote a lot of my ideals with, was with Hugh. But writing is so important, and producing is so important.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, once you're able to say yes, and like, I love sitting in those meetings. Like, it felt like I was in school doing this show too, because I learned a lot. I learned a lot about, I mean, you had to sit in with wardrobe, you had to sit with hair, you had to sit with makeup, you had to sit, and I'm crazy, you know what I mean? So I'm like, you know, like, I think I'm like an Eddie Murphy mind, so I like everything a specific way. So I did build a relationship with the makeup. He's like, look, I want it like this. This is how I want to look. Or with the hair people, or with the wardrobe. And everybody was awesome. Shout out to Awesome Production, man. They were amazing. Mm-hmm. Our set designer was crazy.
Yes.
I mean, it's interesting. Like, I had days I'll go set tearing up because I couldn't believe I was doing this.
Mm-hmm.
It's been the best run ever, and I that's why I can't wait till y'all see the show, and you know, I can't wait to see my castmates too. They are legitimately my friends.
We're in the present right now, but let's take it back to the beginning. How did you end up in comedy to begin with? And you're from Chicago. You're from the West Side. Shout out to the West Side.
it's an interesting story. I mean, I tell it as much as anybody listen to it. I made the decision my senior year in high school, right? I did a play. I went to Crane High School on the West Side. And, you know, when you go to a real hood school, like, they don't support nothing. So they'll boo anybody off stage. They don't care who you are. You can be in a saying a positive speech. Like, man, we don't care about living our life right, you know? They'll yell out anything. But we did this play, and the teacher let me write a lot of my scenes and my jokes. And I remember getting that first roar of laughter from something I wrote. I'm like, oh, I'm killing. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's when that hit, it was like, oh, this is it. And I remember walking around school for like that whole week, because we performed that whole week for each class. So we did it for the freshmen and for sophomores and for juniors and seniors. And like, everybody was treating me like I was some type of star after this play.
Okay.
I'm like, man, this is where it's at. And like, I remember, like, they let me, not necessarily, they gave us a period off. So I just had time to sit in the auditorium. This is 100% a true story.
Okay.
I sat in this auditorium by myself, and found myself just talking to God, like, man, I don't know nobody, but I promise you, this is what I want to do. I don't, just whatever you can do to help that happen. This is what it is. This is all I can see myself doing.
Love me, love me, love me.